Previews in Lightroom allow you to view the photos that you're working on. RAW and DNG files require a preview to be generated in order to actually see the image. When you import your photos, you probably notice this Build Previews option at the top right in the file handling panel. This isn't necessarily an important setting to worry about at that stage, because you can always build previews at any time. In fact, I tend to keep mine to either minimal or standard. Previews take time to generate, so the smaller they are, the faster the images will import. But if you've ever clicked on a photo and zoomed it at 100%, you'll see that it will initially appear very pixely and it will be loading the file. What it's doing is it's generating a one-to-one preview. The one-to-one previews are larger files, but they allow you to zoom in quickly to the photos to check for focus or sensor spots or whatever you need to do. It builds that preview so you can view it at 100%. To build previews inside of the library module, go up to Library, Previews, Build One-to-One Previews. A window will pop up asking you if you want to build the previews for just that one photo that you have selected or for all of the photos inside of that folder. Odds are you probably want to build the previews for all of those photos. But why would you want to do this? Well, let's say that you have some photos that you took and you want to do a lot of processing to them, or you want to check them all for focus really quickly. It's a good idea to build all of those one-to-one previews and just let it kind of sit and do its thing, because it'll take a few minutes depending on how many previews you're building. And then when it's finished, you can quickly zoom into 100% without having to wait for that photo to load each time. You can also discard these previews at any time. The previews can take up some space on your computer, especially if you have hundreds of files or even thousands of files with these one-to-one previews. To remove these previews, go to Library, Previews, Discard One-to-One Previews. Now, don't worry about this setting. Don't overthink it. This is not going to delete your photos. This just removes the previews from your photos. And again, here it's asking me, do I just want to discard this one specific photo or all of the previews in this folder? I'll go ahead and click Discard All. Now, if I click on that photo to view it at 100%, it needs to rebuild that preview for me because I just discarded it. But because I have that preview, I can zoom in and out really quickly without having to wait for it to load. Now, another thing that's good to do is to automatically set those previews to discard after a certain time frame. To do that, go up to Lightroom, Catalog Settings, and under File Handling, you can set a time frame on when you want to automatically discard those one-to-one previews. I would recommend having one of these top three settings selected. For this computer, I'm going to select after 1 week. Now, this is catalog specific, so if you have more than one catalog, you'll need to go in and set this for each of your catalogs. And here, as you can see, you can also set some of the other options. For that standard preview size, you can choose how large you want it to be. Of course, the larger it is, the more space it's going to take up. And preview quality is pretty self-explanatory as well. The higher the number, the better the quality, the larger the file again. I like to see my images high quality, so I'll go ahead and select High.